And this is Smudge. And behind the camera is Rebecca. And we're going to take off. Ready, set? Smudgy, right? Good girl. So this is what we call a gap obstacle. The dog has to decide if we fit. What a nice girl. What a good girl, Smudgy. Forward. Good girl. Nice job. Nice job. Smudge, right? Good girl. Good girl. Thank you very much. What a nice job. Forward. So you'll see me touching the obstacle as we pass. That lets her know that I know it's there. Good girl. Good girl. Forward. Nice job. Forward. Up, let's go. Good girl. Okay, in a couple moments, we're going to come up to introducing her to what we call height obstacles. They're not on the ground, they're over the ground. Good girl. Right. And you're going to see this obstacle is very low. We're teaching her to point at it with her nose. Halt. Right. What a nice job, good girl. So we're going to repeat this a couple times. Good girl. Forward. And you can see how enthusiastically she's taking me to it and touching it with her nose. Eventually, this will be higher and higher till it's almost at my head. Forward. And she'll just be looking at it. And then a couple weeks, she'll be taking me around it. For now, watch your leg, Rebecca. I'm just going to swing it open and set myself up for when we come back. Forward. And these are just obstacles she takes me around, weaving and weaving. You gotta pull me to the left. Good girl. Good girl. Good job. Very nice, sweetheart. Very nice. These are a little tougher for dogs to point out. They're smooth with the road. Wheelchair ramps. Forward. Good girl. Good job. That's my girl. And you can see Smudge's tail wagging. I have a feeling she really, really likes doing this stuff. Forward. Halt. And right. And here comes another gap. What a good girl. Today is her first time with gap obstacles. Forward. That's my girl. That's my girl. Whee! Very nice. Good job. Halfway there. So if you're just tuning in, folks, we're at the Guide Dog Foundation for the Blind in Smithtown, New York. This is my friend Smudge here, and she's in her fifth week of her formal guide dog training. And we're working on various types of obstacles, and I'm kind of describing them as we get there. Okay? And we're going to make a left. And left. Good girl. Whee! Let's go. What a good girl. So can you see, folks, I'm keeping pressure on the harness. If you have a time to see that, till she stops and the harness goes like this and she won't go past that obstacle. As training goes on, I'll push that harder and harder and harder. Forward. Good girl. Good girl. Good job, Smudgy. Left. Up, let's go. Good girl. Good girl. What a nice job. Smudge forward. Good girl. Beautiful job. If you'll notice for now, anyway, she's being very, very good and keeping straight as we approach a curve. That's not easy, especially when the slant is diagonal. Left. Hop up. Let's go. Good job. So, in about 2 weeks, this would look something like this. I wouldn't touch it, and I tell her forward, and when she doesn't go, I reward her for that, and she learns that when I touch this, it's okay to go. Forward, good girl. We call that intelligent disobedience. Forward. What a good girl you are. Forward, through the puddle. Good girl. A lot of people ask, do you teach dogs to go around puddles? The answer is no, because we need the dog going straight across the street, and I would just tell folks to wear good boots. Forward. Halt. Left. Good girl. Very nice. Very nice. Good girl. Good girl. Swing that around. Watch your legs, Rebecca. Forward. Up, up. Let's go. Up, up. Good girl. Good girl, Smudge. Where's my curb? Where's my curb? Whoa. Come on. Let's redo that. Smudge, forward. I think there's a smell on the ground here. You can see she's getting to a place where there's no real reason why she wouldn't want to step here. I have a feeling there's something smelly on the ground. Left. Up. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl, Smudgy. So we're all done. If Allison or anyone has any questions, I'd be happy to answer them.
What's next in Smudge's training?
Well, last week we did Smudge's what we call a blindfold check-in. That's to see that she has, while I'm blindfolded, she has the ability to pull me, as you've seen her pull very positively, that it's easy to follow. She's stopping for curbs, and as you can see, she's stopping very well for curbs, and that she has a good grasp, but a good grasp of obstacle avoidance, and you saw some of that today. So she passed that with flying colors, and what we're going to be doing next is we go to busier towns, more crowded places, malls, Flushing, Queens, Manhattan. We'll be taking Smudge on the escalator probably next week or the following week, and trains and subways, and then any specialized thing that someone who may be matched to her may need. And we're going to get all that in 5 weeks. Okay, anything else?
What's your favorite, aside from Smudge being awesome, any fun little quirks or fun facts about Smudge that you've discovered while working with her?
Smudge is a serious worker. She's actually taken a little while to be affectionate with me. She's kind of tells folks how things are going to be. She's going to be a wonderful guide dog because of that. This is where we have to go. And I have a feeling she's going to be a dog that sometimes folks need a dog if their orientation isn't like you may want it to be. If it's not quite where they'd like it to be, you need a dog that's going to insist, home is this way. And I think this is going to be that type of dog. I don't think she'll be easily swayed. Yeah, if you see her tail wagging, she loves doing this stuff, but she's not giddy. She's not, you could have a dog that's really antsy here. She loves, let's see if we can do this. I'll ask her to heel and watch how excited she is to heel. Smudgy, heel. That's not very exciting, but she has, when I got her, she would jump into heel. Yeah.
All right, well, for more information, where can people go to learn more about the guide dog
program? Well, folks can go to guidedog.org. We are naturally a nonprofit organization that gives dogs free of charge to folks who are blind or visually impaired. You can follow us on Facebook and Instagram. And yeah, if you'd like to donate or get involved in any way, get hold of us on guidedog.org. Okay, folks? So I'd like to thank Anna, Rebecca, Allison, Smudgy Smudge, and all of you. Have a great weekend. Thanks for checking in with us.